Find out what's about to happen on Mars, coming up next on The Edge. And greetings, fellow connoisseurs of all things fringe, unconventional, and edgy. I'm your host, J. Jordan Hawk, and you're watching On the Edge. Well, the planet Mars is going to be in the news a lot this week, and that's because NASA is at it again. Yes, they have sent another rover to the Red Planet, with the singular goal of pissing off fringe theorists like myself by once again exploring every part of Mars except the Cydonia region, where the face on Mars is located. The rover, named Perseverance, will land this Thursday, February 18th, 2021. If you happen to be watching this video years from now, sorry buddy, you missed it. Now, why is sending probes to Mars even newsworthy these days? It's been done so often that we easily forget that something like only 40% of our missions to Mars actually succeed. So, the media will be watching to see if this probe becomes the latest victim of NASA hubris. But that's not what's creating all the suspense. This mission is extra special because Perseverance carries with it the first space helicopter, dubbed Ingenuity. Now, we can't say the first extraplanetary aircraft because the Soviets had balloons floating around on Venus way back in the 1980s. But hey, the Soviet Union doesn't exist anymore, so who's going to object? Never mind. Let them have that record. We get to say we have space helicopters on another world. So what if it's not going to actually do much of anything? This helicopter can only fly a sum total of 90 seconds before its batteries run out and it has to recharge. Not that dissimilar to my cell phone. But flying on Mars at all may prove difficult beyond simply keeping those batteries charged. Mars has less gravity than Earth, and its atmosphere is very thin, which means poor Ingenuity has to rotate four blades, two in opposite directions of the other, at about eight times faster than an Earth-based helicopter in order to generate lift. No wonder it gets tired so fast and needs to recharge. So, its primary mission is really just to see if this can even work. Call it a proof of concept for space helicopters. And even if it does work, it then has to survive the horrific cold temperatures on Martian nights while it's recharging. Soviet space balloons didn't have to survive the cold. They were on Venus. Do you know how hot it is on Venus? Why aren't we sending our space helicopters to Venus instead? Tim Kanem, who is in charge of the Ingenuity project, had this to say of the negative 100 degree temperatures on Mars that Ingenuity has to survive. We have these 90-second flights, but then a lot of the time is spent running the heater. I joke that we are a heater that occasionally flies. I love it when scientists try to sound funny and it just comes across as awkward instead. But hey, don't quit your day job, Mr. Kanem. You just work on keeping Ingenuity flying and let me handle the jokes. I'm a professional YouTuber. In either sense, if space helicopters aren't edgy enough for you, and they're barely edgy enough to hold my interest, just wait to hear what Perseverance is looking for on Mars. There is a reason NASA is landing this little guy on the Jezero crater, which used to be a lake. It's the perfect place, exobiologists believe, to look for signs of ancient microbial life on the Red Planet. It'll collect samples and store them in containers for future rovers to pick up and return to Earth. Now, I've heard the public moaning about all this search for microbial life on other planets. Who cares about microbes? We want to discover alien civilizations. Well, this is where it potentially gets edgy. According to a recent article in Salon entitled Why Some Scientists Believe Life May Have Started on Mars by Nicole Carlos, some scientists suspect that life on Earth may in fact have originated on Mars. It evolved on the Red Planet and was likely distributed to Earth due to asteroid collisions on Mars and our solar system's early history, impacts that would have shot debris up into space that would have then traveled to Earth before smashing into our planet and seeding life on it. Not exactly how the movie 2001 said it happened, but still, pretty edgy. This isn't all conjecture, by the way. Nearly 160 Martian rocks have already been discovered on Earth, so we know that such transfer does in fact occur. Gary Ruvkin, professor of genetics at Harvard Medical School, points out that life first appeared on Earth 3.9 billion years ago, which is pretty early in its history, and it was relatively complicated life at that. So, that leaves two possibilities, according to Ruvkin. Quote, either evolution to full-on modern genomes is really easy, or the reason you see it so fast was that we just caught life. It didn't just actually start here. Eric Osfog, a professor of planetary science at the University of Arizona, further points out that Mars cooled off enough to support life in its oceans well before Earth did. So, it's more likely that life evolved there first, and given the prevalence of cosmic bombardments at the time, it would have been very hardy life indeed, certainly capable of making the trip to Earth. That's what might be at stake with this story. On the one hand, we may finally discover life on another planet, which would be edgy in and of itself. But beyond that, it might be our long-lost cousin, or rather, their fossilized remnants. Unfortunately for the suspense, it'll likely be at least a decade before those samples are returned to Earth and analyzed. But if my channel is still around then, I promise to update this story. In the meantime, just take solace in the fact that we are about to be the first country on Earth to put space helicopters on another world. Thank you very much, NASA. I finally have a reason not to watch Netflix this Thursday. And that's our story for today. I'm Jay Jordan Hawk. See you next time on The Edge. And if you like edgy content, check out my award-winning young adult novels, Pukuwis the Outcast, A Scout is Brave, and Onwashigi the Dreamer.